especially because I'm lazy. Have you guys ever washed clothes, put them in the dryer, got them out the dryer, put them in your laundry basket, took them to your bedroom, put them in the corner, and forgot about them for a few months? Guilty. I think for me, growing up, I was the only child, so I had to do all the chores around the house. So the other day, I had somewhere to go, and the only shorts that would match my outfit was my white shorts. But I kind of couldn't find them. I was going through all my clean baskets of laundry, looking through clothes, looking everywhere for my white shorts. And this got me to think, what if I change up my laundry routine? Like, I wash clothes, then I put them in the dryer, then I get them out of the dryer, put them in my basket, take the basket to my room, and instead of leaving them in my basket for a few months, I fold them immediately. Like, I don't procrastinate, and I just fold them. I wonder what would happen. Make a lot more sense, doesn't it?
Differentiated centers are just like folding clothes. They matter.
Seriously, just listen. Without differentiated learning centers, you'll be constantly trying to squeeze in time in your schedule to actually teach kids one-on-one or in small groups. On every assessment, you'll get frustrated because all your kids will be in the red because they're below grade level. Simply put, you'll end up finding yourself being completely and utterly miserable. Because you simply just don't have the time to give all your kids what they need. So integrating differentiated learning centers is just as important as folding clothes. Hey fun people! Welcome back to Everything Aja. If you're new here, hi, my name is Aja. I'm a curriculum specialist that helps parents and teachers make learning as fun and engaging as possible. So if this sounds like you, don't forget to subscribe below. Today we are going over why differentiated learning centers matter, as if we didn't just discuss that with the laundry. I vividly remember telling my previous coworker how much I wish I could just do centers all day long. I felt like center time was literally heaven for me and my kids. Like, we were all in our happy place. Recently, she reminded me just how much I loved doing differentiated learning centers. I was actually able to get a full class of EIP fifth graders that were technically reading on kindergarten reading levels, and I got everybody on grade level in order to pass our state standardized test. I've helped so many teachers implement differentiated learning centers in their classroom as well. So today, allow me to help you understand the top 10 benefits of implementing differentiated learning centers. And if you're not doing them already, what are you waiting on? Benefit number one is pretty obvious. Implementing differentiated learning centers allows you to not only remediate, but also advance students in small group. If you have centers going on in your classroom, then you are able to pull a small group or even pull kids one-on-one. While you have a small group of kids, around 5 to 6 kids, this is your time to actually teach them at their level without any interruptions. Because let's be real, it's easier to get 5 or 6 kids to master a skill than it is to get 22 kids to master a skill all at the same time.
True.
With every classroom I've ever seen, all the kids are always on so many different levels. So it's really hard if you're doing whole group all day long to meet every single kid at their level. So benefit number two is implementing differentiated learning centers allows you to do differentiation. The Glossary of Education Reform defines differentiation as a wide variety of teaching techniques and lesson adaptations that educators use to instruct a diverse group of students and diverse learning needs in the same course, classroom, or learning environment. Simply put, you're able to teach kids at all different levels exactly where they are and push them to where they need to go. When you're implementing learning centers, you're able to give students assignments either below or above grade level. Doing centers allows you to integrate all the different learning modalities, such as music or hands-on learning, even kinesthetic learning. Could you imagine learning math while you're able to do some push-ups? For older kids, you can also implement reading circles or even number talks. And the last benefit with differentiation, it allows students to do the assignments at their own pace. Woo-hoo! Now, benefit number three, you're absolutely going to love, but implementing learning centers actually decreases discipline. Because kids are all engaged, you won't see so many kids act out for attention because they're actually doing something that they enjoy. And this goes hand in hand with benefit number four, which is implementing learning centers actually increases student engagement. I'm all about increasing student engagement, so you can see why I had to do this video. When doing learning centers, you won't see so many kids just sitting around because they'll actually be engaged in doing activities that are on their ability level. This eliminates the wasted time. Benefit number five is that it's actually easier to plan for learning centers than it is a whole group lesson. I know, just let me explain. When you're teaching a whole group lesson, there's so many things you have to account for. The hook, the mini lesson, the ticket out the door, the student engagement, homework, independent work. I could keep on going. But when you're planning for a small group, you have the technology station, which pretty much never changes. You have your small group, which kind of always stays the same. You're just switching up the book. And then you're only left with about 2 to 3 more centers. So technically you're only planning for about 10 activities that the kids rotate through the entire week. So you're really only planning for 2 stations. And even at those 2 stations, you can have all the kids do the same task and just make the task different to account for their level. So I stand here today and tell you that planning for small groups is easier than planning for whole group instruction. You can argue with me down below in the comments. Alright, so let's just go to benefit number 6, which is learning centers builds accountability within children. It actually makes kids more responsible because they have to keep up with their work. So once kids understand what tasks they have to do or what assignments they need to turn in at the end of the week, they are responsible for doing those tasks. So it builds up self-motivation and it teaches kids responsibility at a very young age. And not to mention, it puts learning in their hands. Now, most standards actually require kids to have time to actually practice the skill. So benefit number 7 is this is your time to have kids practice the skills you want them to learn. You're always looking for time. Like during a whole group lesson, you don't have much time to allow kids to practice something over and over and over and over again. So instead of wasting your whole group time practicing a skill, you move that activity to your center. And now kids can go over in the corner and practice the skill that you've already reviewed in your whole group lesson. Now, while they're over there practicing, yes, they're going to talk, because benefit number 8 is that implementing differentiated learning centers in your classroom actually increases social skills. Kids are able to socialize with their peers while they're doing the assigned task. Now, you will want an elephant's ear and make sure that everybody is on task, but I promise you, if you give kids the freedom to talk and be kids, they're going to do this and they're going to do this correctly. Now, many younger kids actually get overstimulated with all the activities within their normal school day. So implementing differentiated learning centers gives you benefit number 9, extra time to allow for indirect learning. So you guys all know the importance of learning through play. If you're new to education, check out this video. I'll also link it down below. But I go over the importance of learning through play. Well, implementing centers allows young ones to get the opportunity to actually learn indirectly. Now, if you're new to implementing learning centers or you just want a refresher, because let's be real, we went an entire year with online teaching, so you might be a little rusty, I have you covered in next week's video of how to set up differentiated learning centers. So make sure you subscribe so you don't miss that video. All right, so benefit number 10, it makes life less stressful. Yes. Who needs stress these days? We have enough to worry about where we don't need to be stressing about centers. With learning centers, pretty much a lot of the activities kind of repeat themselves and they kind of go in a cycle. And you only have to plan for centers once a week, so the next time you think about differentiated learning centers, think of it as folding up your laundry. It truly matters. And you don't want to do this.